telling me about some spots in the Finzi, which we'll look at in a bit, and vocalize a bit. How much have you sung today?
Not a ton. I would say about 15 minutes. Okay. So a little bit of getting into the space.
Yeah.
Mostly just some simple vowel work.
Okay.
Just keeping the voice engaged. Just trying to keep the threat of the cold weather from doing too much up here. Yeah. Although
cold weather in Texas, 75.
I know, right? After my body's acclimated to the different temperature, it's like going back to normal temperatures in Maine is suddenly chilly.
It would be.
Yeah.
Why don't you walk around and show us to some lip bubbles?
Challenges I've had to really confront lately is just that of my anxiety overall.
Yeah.
Because while performance anxiety is ever an issue, just the anxiety in the day-to-day moments is still kind of an issue that I haven't really done anything about lately. So today I've been doing a little bit of intentional sort of mind exercises, just trying to find different ways to release it and.
Mm-hmm.
I found a couple of different just sort of physicalities that I can sort of, or I guess like ways to sort of think of my body as I just kind of do normal day-to-day things that aren't related to singing. So that could have something to do with it, I think.
Sure.
Yeah.
Well, it can be very soothing to move, you know, in a real free-flowing manner, you know?
Yeah.
And getting out and being in the sunlight is always really good for, you know, mood elevation, some of those foods that that tend to help with our serotonin levels, your cold water fish like salmon, and a lot of the omega-3 containing foods, walnuts in particular.
Yeah.
So a walnut encrusted salmon fillet.
That doesn't seem like the worst thing in the world. I'm gonna try
it doesn't seem like the worst thing in the world at all, actually. Okay, so keeping the movement kind of, you know, fluid and stuff. How's about we do
Oh, no.
up a little higher. So what I like to do is alternate. So let's do da 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 da, and then da 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 da. So
sure,
kind of down in that range where it was going really well, and then we pair that with the other.
Okay.
Da 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 da. Da do da do da, da do da do da do da do.
That's interesting. I mean, you didn't necessarily open it more; you lateralized a little bit, but
yeah,
it worked. How did that feel in your?
It was I think I wasn't. I was paying attention to when I lateralized it, but before then, I wasn't super cognizant of the structure in my mouth, but I think I felt it a little bit more. I felt it sort of, I tried not to spread it in the mouth and the lips, but I tried to put it a little bit on the side of the molars a little bit more.
Right. I get that.
So yeah, I think it felt more open.
Okay.
It felt a little bit.
I like the quality. Yeah. How about we try, let's go one notch further and let's do.
Da do da do da do da do.
Da
do da do da do da do.
Da
do da do da do da do. Do da do da do.
Think a little more daw, just a little more aw in your O.
Sure.
Do da do da do da do da.
Okay.
Do da do da do da.
Now try the more rounded closed O.
Do da do da do da do da.
Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, do da. Awareness, particularly side, you know, when you do the side-to-side stretch, that kind of feeling of the stretch, kind of in the pillars area there. Okay, now try it.
That was
so, yo-ya.
Yo-ya, 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 yo-ya.
Okay, try the ya-yo one time.
Ya-yo.
Rather than portrait stretch, okay. Feeling that in the yo there.
With the yo, okay.
Uh-huh.
Yo, ya, yo, ya, yo, ya, yo, ya. Yo, ya, yo, ya, yo, ya, yo, ya.
So, how about just massage? So, yeah, more. Because I'm kind of hearing
got it.
A little more of that direction.
Sure. distinct with that vowel is for it to almost feel like it's on the uvula, and I don't know how much of that is correct. And it always throws me off when I feel that, especially when the tongue sort of releases from the back of the throat slightly, and I have that sudden color change when it moves position. It's a little, it throws me off in the moment, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. So I'm not 100% sure on the correct placement of that one. So,
well, you know, you might do some things where you go back and forth. And just toggle back and forth. Just try that once. Let's do Yeah, I mean, your vibrato rate's very steady. The ring is very constant throughout.
I think it must just be a muscle memory thing. I think the feeling of speech is not quite the same as in singing, of course.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's just not a vowel I come across too frequently.
No,
so I think
I
just
have that. Using it as a means to an end.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, some of the shaping to try to kind of nudge the ah and the o, you know, just a little more brilliant and ringing, that's all.
Yeah.
Let's do, since you talked about onsets.
Yes.
As you said.
The first onset.
The first one, right.
And then, O Friend Unseen.
O Friend.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, part of it is because the coordination with Anna is a little funky in those moments.
Right, you have to start right.
Right, and like with the first one especially, because I always feel like I'm not giving her the cue she needs, so I'm a little self-conscious of that one. And then with O Friend, I feel like I'm just so zoned in on the timing, I kind of forget to do the engagement correctly. So a different reason for each one.
Yeah.
So.
Well, and the first one is made more awkward because you have that measure of rest.
Yes. Yeah.
Which is in 2/4, not 4/4. So you've had her finish playing there, you know, she plays. Which then, as you go from the A to the A, we see it kind of release.
Yeah.
So yeah, just do a little jiggle there.
Okay.
whatever you do, come in fairly assertively. Mm-hmm. It's the first time we hear you.
Right.
The piano is marked piano. I think she needs to hear the breath in.
Right.
Just subtly, or that there's something that you do that kind of cues her. I mean, not that you want to do some big thing with your head, but I think just an audible breath, because you're this far apart, and I think just a little.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's try. I'll play the bars for 2/4.
Okay.
So we get. The tempo is a little nebulous because that beginning, it kind of, we have the little triplet thing, and then we get the little Poulenc chords there, which reminds me of, a number of Poulenc songs.
Such creative.
And so it's like feeling, all right, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when she plays, then there's no
confusion.
There's no confusion between the two of you.
Makes sense.
So then we'll come back to an old man of these.
Okay.
Oh, Friend Unseen, she plays before you, of course.
Yes. Yeah. Just an eighth note though, so.
Yeah.
It's a little.
Do you feel like it's the vowel?
I think it's just. I think it might just be a mentality thing, because when I get there, remind myself of what was beforehand.
So we have. There's kind of the wandering before that, and then.
Oh, friend unseen, unborn, unborn.
Yeah, it's. I think it's coming off of. Because I'm coming off of that that C sharp, and then it just sort of I think it's the mentality switch. Ready for it in the bar beforehand, and I don't feel like I'm ready until the note has already happened. Mm-hmm. So
I would suggest this. When you hear her release, because she's playing, when she releases, you're breathing in. So when you hear her release that chord,
oh, friend unseen.
Okay.
Yeah, because I think before what I was doing is I was breathing and then holding it until that moment.
Oh,
that's
I think when you just hear her release, it's like,
yeah.
Oh, friend unseen. And at that point, you want the, the most warm, sincere sound you've got.
Right, and I can only be able to achieve with a good breath.
Yeah. Okay, so I'll play that last little stretch there.
Okay.
Friend unseen, unborn, unknown.
And I didn't help you there because I kind of was like, oh, geez, what's
that? Okay. There's a blues chord in there.
Yeah. One more time, same
sure,
thing?
Sure, yeah. Okay.
Oh, friend unseen, unborn.
So I think just, you know, when you rehearse with her, just like right in tempo, you know, she releases that chord, you're breathing in on her eighth rest, she goes, and then that gives you basically a beat of a breath in.
Yeah. I think that might just be a part of my technique that might have just fallen by the wayside, is breathing in tempo, because I think I do it sometimes, but not all the time, so might be something to touch up on a little bit for myself.
Yeah, breathing in tempo, thinking of the vowel you're about to sing as you breathe in.
Right.
And you know, the emotion of what you want to say. Mm-hmm. All of those things will color that whole process of breathing in.
Yeah.
As you said, you know, with the tension. Mm-hmm. Okay, now we have an old Maionides stretch.
Yeah.
So we haven't really gone on terribly high today. That does take you up fairly high.
Yeah.
Sure. So how about just a little rollover? Brilliant boss, that's a brilliant A.
really just what I'm feeling right now. Yeah. So, I mean, end result still feels a little bit more constricted by this.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
That's probably why the A is a little bit strange, too.
Yeah. How's your raspberry done?
It's been good. I think I'm having a little bit of, I think it's just the placement of either the tongue or the lips that it's, because I think in our lessons a little bit I've had some issues with it too, where the airflow, or not the airflow, but the mechanism sort of,
how about just stops. Off with your tongue out? Yeah.
Exactly the way I want to, but I think it's just because it's on a three, there's a different vowel movement.
Three?
Yeah.
Let me hear it one more time without playing the accompaniment.
Okay. The whole line?
Yeah.
And hold me on, it is the blind.
Pause just a second.
Uh-huh.
How did it feel when you went to old?
Well, I think it's, I'm trying to, I guess I'll explain a little bit what's happening in my mouth. I'm trying to like minimize the transference into different consonances.
Yes,
like
right.
Old, I'm trying not to say old,
yes.
I'm just saying old, basically. So it felt okay. I think,
I have a suggestion.
Okay.
Okay, you have the word and right before it, which is, you can basically sing an ad.
Yeah.
And old.
Okay.
Yeah. So take advantage of that. We were just pairing up the at and the o earlier.
Sure.
And old.
What do you think?
Different. Yeah. Different mentality.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
And old me on it is the blind. Said it 3,000 years ago.
Yeah, that was really pretty on the F sharp.
Yeah.
Does it feel good?
Yeah.
It sounded very easy.
Much freer, yes. It felt easy, yeah.
So often it's not the phrase itself, it's the phrase or two before. Barbara Dodger,
you've mentioned that,
blow me away, because I would be saying, I'm having trouble with this. And she would go back like two phrases and said, make sure that you do X here. And I would go, okay, but we're not fixing that. She'd go, well, just try it. And I would do it, and I would go, dang it.
Well, yeah, it's like once you have the, like once you've engaged the breath in a certain phrase, I feel like you've set the tone for the entire phrase.
And
when
so
you mentioned that,
you want to start well.
Right.
You want to start well. So you don't want to be nebulous about how you start that. Yeah, you want to know, where am I going?
Yeah.
Where am I going? Mm-hmm. And again, so that comes back to that idea of the intentional breath.
Right.
That you have the thought that you want to convey here is all the way through 3,000 years ago, and it starts with how you set it up there at and old.
Yeah.
Last time.
Okay. So, yeah.
And as we said the other day, I know it's marked pianissimo, but let's get it free. I think it's piano and pianissimo in intent.
Yes.
But don't feel like you have to throw all of your knees back.
Yeah.
We want to hear a pretty line.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I guess this is more of an orchestration thing or an arrangement thing, but it's like there is, because the way that the piano is interacting in that line, it's not super high in the register, but it's very rhythmically sparse. So it sort of reduces, it's almost like the harpsichord thing, where if you want to have a section forte, you diminish the line a bit more. And if you want to have a section piano, you play just the chords and whatnot. So I guess that's just the composer way.
And especially right after the wind, and the piano, is kind of doing this contrary motion thing.
Yeah.
And then suddenly we're kind of in second recitative,
Yeah.
Which is really, really interesting. Yeah. It's a very sectional setting, and yet it works.
Yeah.
Good. Okay, so what are you taking with you from today?
Today, biggest thing was the intentionality of the onset, and then finding ways to use the colors of the vowels to support the vowels following and not have them feel like they're really fighting each other and having to adjust to previous onsets and whatnot. So,
I'm looking forward to hearing you sing it on Thursday in the big room.
I know, first time it's a big sound. I actually feel good about it, so
yes.
Looking forward.
Yep. All right, well, I'll see you tomorrow with Honest.
Yes.